Factsverse presents 10 strange plants in the world. Number 1. The banyan tree. The banyan tree, Ficus bengalensis, was originally native to India. When growing, it puts down rope-like roots, and as they take root in the soil, they thicken to create more tree trunks. One tree can spread out many meters. In the Calcutta Botanic Gardens, there is a banyan tree with more than 1,700 trunks that is 200 years old. During Alexander the Great's campaign in India, one banyan tree is said to have sheltered 20,000 soldiers. Number 2. The shy plant. The sensitive or shy plant, Mimosa pudicea, is a great curiosity. The compound leaves of the plant fold inward in a tenth of a second and droop with the slightest touch, only to reopen in a few minutes. Once native to South and Central America, today it is a pantropical weed found on all continents. The plant's shyness deters animals from eating it while grazing. Number 3. The bottle tree. The 8 species of baobab tree, genus Adansonia, are also known as bottle trees. These trees not only resemble bottles but store tremendous amounts of water, up to 300 liters or 80 gallons of water. This threatened tree is native to India and equatorial Africa, but mostly lived throughout Madagascar, where it is their national tree. One species grows in Australia. From the Arabic word for fruit with many seeds, buhibab, the baobab tree produces edible monkey fruit and can live as long as 500 years. Its strong root system allows the tree to be quite resistant to drought. Number 4. The resurrection plant. The resurrection plant, also known as Rose of Jericho, Salaginella lepidophylla, is a desert plant that is somewhere between a moss and a fern. The Chihuahuan Desert is its native habitat, where it has an amazing ability to become almost completely desiccated without dying. During dry weather, the stems of the resurrection plant, which never produces fruit, flowers, or seeds, curl up into a tight wad, then uncurl when the plant receives moisture again. Number 5. The baseball plant. Native to South Africa's Great Karoo region, the baseball plant, Euphorbia obesa, is now highly endangered in the wild. Plant collectors have unsustainably harvested this unusual plant almost to the point of extinction in the wild. National and international legislation has now been enacted to protect it. Botanical gardens and plant nurseries grow a lot of Euphorbia obesa, so collectors who want this plant can obtain it from a supplier rather than raid the wild for specimens. Shaped exactly like a baseball, it is a popular ornamental yard plant. Only 20 centimeters, 8 inches tall, it has separate male and female plants. The plant's sap is highly toxic, and if it gets on the skin, it causes severe problems. Number 6. The Venus flytrap. The most famous of all the carnivorous plants, the Venus flytrap, Dionaea muscipula, was named after the goddess of sex and love because botanists noticed the flower looked like a vagina. Oval in shape with a pink interior, the flytrap also has hair-like cilia that are ultra-sensitive for quickly detecting the presence of live insects. When the hairs are triggered, the plant secretes mucilage and its two hinged leaves snap shut. The prey is trapped in less than 1 second. This efficient meat-eating plant is a threatened species. Number 7. The world's most drought-resistant plant. Also called Onyanga, the onion of the desert, the Namibian Welwitschia mirabilis is truly one of a kind and only grows in South Africa. The Welwitschia is composed of only 2 leaves and sturdy roots. The plant's 2 leaves grow continuously throughout its lifetime, an amazing span from 400 to 1500 years. It grows to about 2 meters, 6.5 feet in height, but its width may be greater. The strangest thing about the 2 leaves is how they grow over, around, and on top of each other for years. This plant can survive as long as 5 years without rain. Number 8. The world's largest flower. Rafflesia arnoldi of the Euphorbiaceae plant family is the world's largest individually produced flower. with a single blossom growing to a whopping 3 feet in height and between 15 to 24 pounds in weight, the rusty red and lightly speckled bloom is very rare. Growing in Sumatra's forests, its bloom lasts only for 3 to 7 days. The plant has a unisexual reproductive system and only contains a flower. There are no roots, stems, or fruit. This parasitic plant can contain up to 26.5 liters or 7 quarts of water and attracts pollinating insects through its distinctive odor, a quite pungent, offensive, rotting meat kind of odor. It is so bad, it also has the name corpse plant or corpse flower. Once pollinated, less than 20% of its seedlings survive to bloom themselves. Number 9. The corpse flower. Not to be confused with the previous Indonesian corpse flower plant, Rafflesia, the world's largest flower, there is a second Indonesian carrion plant also known as the corpse flower. The two plants are very different. This second plant, Titan arum, which basically translates as titanic penis, is a tall flower cluster with a purplish phallus-like spire that grows taller than adult men. Titan arum, Amaporphallus titanium, is a carrion flower that attracts pollinating insects to help it create its purple, cream, and green blossoms. Its insect-attracting aroma mimics the odor of a decomposing dead animal. Rather than being the world's largest single flower, the Titan arum is the world's largest inflorescence, a cluster of flowers growing on a stem. Protected by law because of its rarity, the plant's stem, the pedicel, holds up its large inflorescence, which only blooms every 40 years. Number 10. The Red Tide. Haunting the world's coastlines is a terrifying phenomenon known as the Red Tide. The strangest combination of extra nutrients and weather changes causes many tiny seaweeds to multiply. Red in color, the multitude, Algera pelagius, turns the surf to a rusty red color in a phenomenon known as the red tide. The extremely neurotoxic algae are quickly absorbed by the water's shellfish. When contaminated shellfish is ingested by humans, the toxin anesthetizes respiratory pathways and quickly paralyzes the person's limbs. Fatal without treatment and potentially fatal with treatment, it is extremely dangerous. In recent years, provinces and states have closed ocean harvesting during a red tide because of the threat of paralytic shellfish poisoning. Also fatal to ducks and seabirds, this red tide is considered to be the basis of the plague noted in the Bible when water turned to blood. Subscribe for more!